Hi, in this episode we'll be looking at creating a front end for the backend service, backend REST API that we have created earlier in the series. So if you can remember the K application that we created, if you go to, if you're running this application, you will see that there is a REST endpoint called logins that you can see all the logins. But currently there is no data insert in this application. So what we're going to do is we're going to be creating a front end which will allow the users to send a request and persist some data over here over the REST APIs. So we'll be using Angular as the front end framework. Maybe you can use other frameworks such as React or AmberJS. In my case, I kind of like Angular, so maybe in the future tutorials I can add another series on how to work with React.js. For now we'll just go with Angular. So the tools setup wise, you need to have Node.js installed in your application. So Node.js is kind of taking over with the languages. If you are preferring JavaScript, Node.js is the best place to start with. So the latest version is, at the time of recording, is version 6.11.3. So at least you need to have version 6.9 to work with these tutorials. Some dependencies work on that. So you need to have download into your machine and set up the node. If you successfully done with setting up, you will see node-v. We will show you the version of the node. I am actually not in the current version, but I am over 6.9, so I'm good to go. So once you have installed node.js in your application, in your machine, the next thing is to install is to a generator that will generate an Angular application. So the current best option is the Angular CLI. Angular CLI will boilerplate some application for you using Angular. The current version is at Angular 4. So Angular 4 application is created out of single command, so that is very helpful. But you need to install Angular CLI after you have installed Node. After you are installing Node, you will get a Node package manager, or npm for short. If you have set up the Node.js correct, so if you hit npm -v, you will get the Node npm version. This is the Node version, not the Node version, but the npm version. So at this time of the recording, it is 3.10.10. So we have that, and using npm we can install the Angular CLI. It's just a basic command of npm install -g, stand for install globally. That means it will install all over your install generally in your terminal. Not all within your directory of execution, so it will available in globally. So what you have to do is npm install at Angular CLI / just copy and paste this command, so you will get the Angular CLI setup. Current version of the Angular CLI is version 1.4.1 at the time of the recording, but I'm actually a little bit behind. If you say ng-minus version, you will see a little bit older version. It's 1.3.1, but it will do. So what you have to do is, now you have all this setup with you, you can work with the creating a new Angular application as well. So next thing is to have a better tooling support with npm is with Yarn. Npm actually stands for Node Package Manager, but recently there's a new package manager called Yarn. which will help and which will actually speed up your npm installs. From my understanding, Yarn will cache your downloaded dependencies. So if you are referring to the same library again, so you don't have to download again, it will use the local cache and install it. So you can install Yarn as well using npm, just npm install dash dash global or dash g for short, as you see in the Angular CLI, and install the Yarn version, the Yarn package manager. Or you can go to the installation, there are several options, using a Debian package manager or something like that. You can use that as well. I personally like the npm version, so I don't have any other things to be set up. So there are two things, so three things actually, Node, Angular CLI and Yarn. Internally in Angular CLI use Yarn, so it's better to have Yarn. If you have installed Yarn, I think Yarn minus version, maybe minus V, yeah. Yarn minus V will give you the Yarn version. Okay, so the next thing may is I will go to the key application that I have created earlier. You will see an additional folder called app. This is not a standard or something like that. That's for my convenience. I just put everything under app, you know, every day. Now every day is an app. I don't know why. Okay, under app, I will create a web directory that will hold the Angular application. If you are planning to have a React application, the same would go inside here. But if I were to create a mobile application, I will just simply create a new directory called mobile and put that in there. So my plan is to work on an Ionic project as well. Let's see about that in the latest later tutorials. For now, I'm going to be starting with Angular. Okay, you won't see this. I have done so. Okay, good to go. Speed up my development time, I have a little script around here. So the first thing first is, once you install Angular CLI, you will get this new command ng. So if you paste, if you type ng help, you will get a lot of messages saying how to operate ng. But I'm not gonna be walking through every thing at this time, but we are gonna be using each of these things little by little. So to create a new project, the first command would be ng new and the name of the project. Since it's an Angular project, for the simplicity, I will use the name Angular here. Press enter and give it some time. If you have installed Yarn, you can see that installing packages for tooling via Yarn. If you don't have Yarn, they will by default use the npm, which come by default. But it's better to have Yarn. It's significantly sp much more speed than the Node version. So just give it a little time. It will install the Yarn. And other than while it is creating, for the front end code management, I'm not recommending STS because the Angular applications that we write nowadays are based on TypeScript. So I don't think that there is much support at STS with the TypeScript and all the stuff. The best IDE that I recommend is Visual Studio Code. So you can go and download VS Code. Visual Studio Code. Currently, I think it is 1.6, so you can get the Debian or RPM version if you are in Linux, or if you are in Mac, you can download the latest builds. So I will have it linked in the description, so you can go and download these things. So I have already downloaded and installed code, so that's easy for me to work with. Okay, now since the project name is I have given is Angular, it will create a directory called Angular, and inside that you will find the source code. So if you ls here and you just browse around your directory manager, whatever the tool that you use to go inside and see your directories, you will see that there are a bunch of files around here, especially the node modules, the src file, and there's a special README. If you show all the hidden files in Linux, it is Control H, you will see a gitigno file that will help you with ignoring those things as well. So a basic project is created. At the point of this creation, you can actually see this application. All you have to do is go inside the application, and I will make sure, okay, I'm in the directory where I have created the project. Normally, I will check for package JSON with if it is there and comfortable with running ng-serve. So it's another command that we will be using to serve our application if you hit press enter. So the ng-serve will actually, you don't have to set up any local servers or any deployment or whatsoever. Everything is done by Angular CLI. So a basic application is running right now. Since I haven't defined any local port, it will use the default. The local is 4200 port. So if I go here, you can see a small but beautiful web application is created for you. This is in totally in Angular. So next thing you need to do is change this application and see whether it is live reloading and all the stuff is good things are happening here. So I will just dock it to this side and my terminal to this side. I will open another terminal at the same location, and if I have set up my Visual Studio code correctly and I go to the project directory and hit type code and dot meaning here, it will open the Visual Studio code at the point of the project. Awesome. So the project's structure is fairly simple. You can use navigate around this, and all the source code are going to be under source directory, and there is a special section called app, which will contain all your most of the time your app your modules, components. We'll get on to that. Assets will hold all the resources such as images and other stuff. Environments, we'll go into this. Most probably you will be familiar with index.html, but you can see a very small application. You can see here that title is Angular, so our project is Care. We'll just say Care in the title section. Once you hit save, you can see that it's auto reloading, and you can see that over the in the Chrome you will see that it's no longer Angular, it's Care. So it's automatically reloading your stuff. And I'm not gonna go very deep into Angular application development over here, so I'm not gonna be talking about the what is Main.js and how all these project is set up. You can I'm not gonna go in depth on this, but you can find a lot of resources in YouTube if you want to go more deep into these concepts. But I'm gonna be using the I'm hoping that you have a basic knowledge on Angular, so I'm not gonna go into the basic levels. So the app component is where you start your application. So you have app component CSS, app component HTML. This HTML is represented or what you see in this application. So if you get welcome to Care app, it will show immediately that it will be displaying in your HTML browser. So this is the HTML, and this is the test case for the component, and the component itself. We'll be talking about this in a little bit later. how these things. Okay, that is too much. Okay, it's pretty much okay. So app module, we are the modules and all this stuff we'll be talking about in depth a little bit later. But for now, the application is created and in GServing. In the next tutorial, we will see how we can connect this into the backend service. Until then, thank you for watching.